All right, welcome back to another monthly market update. We are in May of 2021. The year is flying by. The market is still red hot. Let's dive in and take a look. As always, if you are not receiving our UC Life magazine, a lot of good stuff in here, let us know and we'll make sure you get on the list. A lot of coupons for local businesses. We feature the pet of the month. That's very, very popular. And new homes coming up for sale. Lots of fun stuff. Let's dive in and take a look. As always, we're going to look at detached homes, single family homes, and condos here in 92122. Okay? We look at the leading indicators of where the market is headed. We're also going to look at what's happening with the median price. So if you're someone thinking about buying or thinking about selling, this is the information that you have to pay attention to because these are the signs of what's to come or where the market is headed. All right, let's talk about detached single family homes first. So we take the last 30 days of last year and compare it to the last 30 days of this year. Okay? Last year, we had 12 new single family homes hit the market. This year, same thing. Last 30 days, we had 12 hit the market as well. That's flat. Pending, they accepted an offer. They go into escrow. Last year, we had 7 go into escrow. This year, we had 9. So that's up 29%. Median home price, pretty much the same as last month. Yet last year, it was a 1,012,000. This year, it's 1,320,000. That's up 31% in 12 months. That number is ridiculously big. Supply, this is the total number of homes for sale in our zip code. Last year, single family homes, there was 14 at this time. This year, there's 7. That number's down 50%. Days on market, we track how long it takes on average for a single family home to sell. Last year, we had 20 days on average. This year, 11. It's down 45%. So real quick for the single family homes, what does all this mean? One of the biggest differences that we're seeing now is obviously you've been hearing the inventory being very, very low in the past several months. And that's true. Last month, we were down 60%. Now it's down 50%. Well, why is that? If 12 came on and 9 came off, you have a remainder of 3, which is causing inventory to go up. Is this a sign of what's to come? Are things starting to change? I don't know. We'll see in the months to come. So continue to watch our monthly market updates to see what happens. What we do know is that we are in a supply and demand industry. So as long as this number keeps coming up, this is the supply, then it should even out the supply and demand. We don't know if that's going to happen yet. This has to change significantly. This number has to double and then double again to get back into a well-balanced market. Okay. So let's talk about condo market. Very, very different. This is kind of consistent across the county, but this is just for 92122. Last year, we had 21 new condos hit the market in the same 30-day period. This year, 31, which is up 48%. Pending sales. Last year, we had 7. This year, we had 27. That's up 286%. So lots of people buying condos. Here's what's different. The median price has actually gone down. $558,000 is the median price last year at the same time. Right now it's 505, down 9%. Way different than the detached single family home market. Supply, total amount of townhouse condos for sale. Last year we had 47, this year we're at 23, down 51%. That number was down 56% last month. So, you know, we'll see. That might be starting to change too. Days on market, they're still selling very fast. So what does all this mean? So if you're a buyer, it looks like you're starting to see more coming on the market, more options for you. I can say the one thing that we're seeing across the county is we track the number of showings that buyers are requesting throughout the county using a system called Showing Time. And we've seen a decrease in the number of showings requested. It hasn't been affected. It hasn't affected the prices yet. Will it? I don't really know. Again, a lot has to change before any of that happens, but is that a sign of things to come? I don't know. Stay tuned and we'll keep you up to speed. If the showings continue to decline, the number of buyers are going to decline. If the number of buyers decline, the number of offers. The number of offers go down, the number of homes remain on the market, which causes inventory to go up, which eventually would affect price. But we'll have to see when that will happen or if that will happen or if these trends continue. So if you're a seller, what we're experiencing is, again, less showings, strong offers, but fewer offers. Inventory is still very, very low, so you're in a very good position. We typically peak out in our inventory levels in the San Diego real estate market in the month of September. This year may have been different. We're thinking that we're going to peak out a little bit sooner because of the huge demand and sense of urgency that we experienced at the beginning of the year that normally doesn't happen. So if you're a seller, I wouldn't wait. I wouldn't wait. Make it happen sooner than September if you're planning on selling. If you're a buyer, now everybody's talking about, well, Ryan, they either have this huge sense of urgency to buy, or they say, I'm gonna wait for the prices to come down. And I always tell them, what is in your plan? If you're a buyer and you say, Ryan, I wanna buy something and sell it in 2 years, I would probably tell you, don't do that. Rent. That doesn't make sense where our market cycles are. There's a strong possibility that your house will be worth less in 2 years than it is now. I don't know, nobody has a crystal ball, but that wouldn't be a very smart decision. But if you're someone that's thinking about buying something and holding it for 7 to 10 years, well, of course, the market history says that it's going to be worth more in 7 to 10 years than it is now. So take advantage of those interest rates. But it all depends on what your plan is. So sit down with your real estate agent, come up with the best plan for you guys, best strategy, and get a good idea of where we are in our current market cycle compared to where you want to be in your exit strategy. Okay, very important. So talk to your real estate agent, they can help you out with that. And if you guys have any questions about any of this information or anything in real estate in general, please reach out. We're always here to help. We'll see you next month. Take care.